Oh boy, cake! Let's go to the castle post-haste! Hello everyone, and welcome to another random gameplay video. This one is of Super Mario 64, and I'm making this because I am utterly stuck at New Super Mario Bros. U. Although I have stubbornly been trying to beat the levels, but anyway, I would like to make some video rather than no video. It's just that I'm so stubborn, I haven't been really working on anything else except Super Mario 64, New Super Mario Bros. U, excuse me. So, instead I'm just going to make a video of Super Mario 64 and relax! But wait, how am I recording this? Because as I told you before, I have issues recording my N64, SNES, and NES because I have recording issues with my camera. It gets a file failed error because the video signal is weird and it can't lock onto it. So I'm actually recording this on the PC, but wait! I wasn't able to do that before because it was too laggy, I said. Well, that's because I got a new program that I would love to show off here, and that's why I'm making this video here. On top of, you know, just making some gameplay. It is called FFSplit, and it is a fantastic screen recording program. Needless to say, I'm emulating this. I don't prefer emulation because it's not like the real game, but I guess I do what I have to do in order to make videos on certain games and stuff like that at times, providing that the emulation is accurate enough. I'll show you what I mean later on in this video. But anyway, let's just get on with this and say that FFSplit is fantastic! I was going to make a video on FFSplit later on, like when I make an actual walkthrough using FFSplit, but I figure that I'll do it now because, as I said, I'm not making any progress in New Super Mario Bros. U, and on top of that, I figure that FFSplit could be a very useful program to you as well for making your own game videos or tutorials or whatever you use for screen capturing. As you can see, the quality, fantastico, and that's what I didn't have with Cam Studio for certain games. It was just very, very choppy. Not to bash Cam Studio or anything like that, but it was a resource hog, so I couldn't use it for everything. I mean, Cam Studio is definitely good, but you need a pretty powerful machine to run it smoothly. Or at least that's what it seems like to me. I haven't been able to get it to run any smoother than I have in other videos that you've seen me use it in. So, as you can see, the princess is kidnapped again. Big surprise! So, let's go get the power stars and, you know, restore the power to the castle, open doors, and stuff like that, starting with the Bob-omb Battlefield! Let's go. So, FFSplit is going to be the program that I use to bridge the gap that I had between me playing modern games and me playing classic games like N64, Genesis. Well, I was able to record certain Genesis games again with Cam Studio, as I said, but it depends on the performance of Cam Studio. SNES, NES, N64, all those sort of games that I couldn't do before with my setups, I can now do with FFSplit, and that is spectacular. So I have opened up a huge range of games that I can do now with screen capture technology and whatnot. And hello, my good buddy. Oh god! Run from the chompiness! Do not pet the chomps. Do not feed the chomps. Anyway, I'm just going. Oh god, bubble right in my face. Surprise attack, but luckily it only does one damage, but whatever. As you can see, this is going to be awesome because I can make walkthroughs on so many more games, especially since the N64 era was a pretty big part of my childhood fun, and, well, you know, in terms of video games. So I'm going to be really, really pleased to be using this in the future, but, you know, I've got other games to do that I have planned out before I start using FFSplit stuff, you know, unless I do some tutorials and stuff like that as well along the way, but yeah, give FFSplit a try, but you might need a screen, not a screen capture program, you need a video editor that has the capability to crop out the screen that you're recording, because FFSplit does not have the ability to set a specific screen region that I know of. I'm pretty new to the program right now, so it might just be something that's outside of my knowledge base. So what I do is I record over the whole window, and then I just crop out the screen that has the game footage with it, and then it's gonna fill the entire screen. So we have Big Bob-omb here. Oh no, how do I defeat him? And I completely missed that. Oh, come on, come on. This is not hard. Okay, do not throw him off the edge, by the way, or he'll accuse you of cheating. And wait for him to lock onto you and go around the other backside and throw him again one more time, and he's a goner. Oh no! I was trying to sync that to the music, and I sort of did a bad job. Okay, lock onto me already. If he doesn't like lock onto your position and start moving straight forward to you, he goes as just as fast as you do, and you can't get behind him. I believe in the DS version, he talks something about that it's a battle of mustaches or something like that. It's kind of ridiculous, but it's pretty funny. I was just thinking of that at the time that he was doing that dialogue. Anyway, I got the first power star out of 120. Yeah, there's not going to be enough time to do all the stars in this gameplay. This is just a test video of sorts anyway. Oh no, I can open one of the doors, but I don't want to go do that just yet because there's more to do. I'm going to go race Koopa the Quick. Let's go! Or let's-a go. That works too. I'm not going to talk to any of the bob-ombs that open the cannons just yet, because I'm just, as I said, doing some random gameplay and stuff like that. Alright, if you think you're so fast, let's do it! And he's ridiculously slow in this race. Don't use any warps, because I'm pretty sure he'll accuse you of cheating. If I'm not mistaken, or at least if he sees you using warps, he'll accuse you of cheating, so just saying. I could be wrong about that, though. Anyway, let's go around, because I'm pretty sure he has accused people of accused me of cheating and people of cheating before. Although it's been a while since I've played this thing, and I could be thinking of the DS version or something like that at the moment. I don't really worry about it at the moment. I'm just super excited to be showing this program because it's spectacular. I'm just sort of spouting anything that comes to mind at the moment. But then again, when don't I do that? That's kind of what I do around here. So we're going up to the top of the summit again. Oh geez, I failed to cut the corner terribly, and we are so far ahead of Koopa the Quick. It's embarrassing. Alright, where is he? Come on. Still waiting. It could be like another half minute or so, actually. I can hear his feet pitter-pattering along the way here. Oh, another thing about FFSplit is that the audio and the video are slightly out of sync, by like 4 frames or so each and every time, so it's consistent. So you'll also need an editor that can manage to resync the, you know, you would manually resync the audio, but I mean an audio that would let you do that. I mean an editor that would let you do that, excuse me. Bah, I'm getting so flubbed up in my words and because I'm so excited, but whatever. Yeah! Another star completed, and I'm gonna go to the next level to show you what I mean about emulation not being perfect. Where is, I believe it's this door, if I'm not mistaken? That leads to Womp's Fortress. Yes, it is. And there's a toad beneath my feet, but I'm not going to talk to him. I'm just going to go inside and chip off Womp's block. Oh, ho, ho, I think they just made a funny there. Yeah, it's just another tutorial. This is what I mean about emulation not being perfect. See the jaggedy lines between the objects? Yeah, you wouldn't be able to see that if it was the normal system and stuff like that, so it's not quite perfect. Emulation is never quite perfect. That's why I don't like to use emulation for walkthroughs, because I fear that it won't be an accurate walkthrough, so to speak. So I'm currently working on other options to see how accurate I can get Super Mario 64 and other games, basically. Basically, I want to get them as accurate as possible if I'm going to emulate them, and yeah, you get the idea. It's accurate enough, it seems to be, but it's not, you know, it doesn't necessarily feel like Super Mario 64 in that sort of sense. Like, over here, you can tell the cutoff on the graphics where one of the hidden stars are. No, I can't ground pound that. I have to shoot at it with this cannon down here, but I didn't mean to jump off there to show the cannon. I just simply fell off there because I'm an idiot. anyway... So, I'm also using the Moopin 64 emulator, which is the most accurate N64 emulator I could find. Project 64 does not come close to Moopin 64 in the slightest. Just saying, just giving you a little warning there, whoever has Project 64 and is swearing by it. Try Moopin. I'm pretty sure you will not be disappointed. Oh, and you can kill the Womps by ground pounding their back like that. I haven't really been teaching the controls in this video because this is a random gameplay video, not a walkthrough. Well, other than, you know, showing you FFSplit and stuff like that. So I guess it's so it's technically a walkthrough for not a walkthrough. It's to tell you about FFSplit and some of the stuff about it. But I think you get what I'm saying. We got a very blurry Womp here, but that's okay. We can still beat him. Come on, slam down, slam. There you go, good boy. And then I do that two more times. Come on, slam. And dunk. Okay, that was not a dunk in the slightest. It's a butt stomp. No. How did I manage to avoid that? I don't know what. And he managed to avoid my ground pound. Well, even though he didn't really avoid it, I just completely flubbed them. Maybe that's emulation issues. I don't know. It probably isn't. That's just me messing up. I'm just kidding. And there's another star. Yeah. If I was making a walkthrough of this, I would do. I would focus more on the stars, like doing them world by world, if at all possible, in the most the tightest way possible. Like, I would have to skip on the ones in the early levels that need the red switch until the red switch area opens up that you have to look up at the ceiling at, and you get what I mean, where the light comes up in the lobby. Yeah, I'm gonna take myself a shortcut here and forget about the rest of that. Yeah, I knew about that shortcut before. I'm just messing around in Super Mario 64, as I told you before, just to show you the awesomeness that is this program. And after this I'll probably do, oh god no, why do I keep messing up that spot? It's not that hard, dang it. And yeah, I'm gonna do one more star after this. I'm just gonna race all the way up to the top and then do one at Dire Docks? Is it Dire Docks? That's the next water world, like. It probably is, because that's the first thing that's coming to mind here. I don't know why I can't think of the name of the next world at the moment, but I feel like I'm derping because this is a classic game and I should know this stuff, like, instinctively. Oh jeez! How could I fail Bullet Bill, how could I fail such easy platforming? This is like platforming 101. Alright, pop back out. I'll stop rushing. I'll just gently go around the curves and do things, and then just normally, gently, and this one's an elevator. There we go. Why wouldn't that suck if the emulation wouldn't let me go up that elevator? I'd just be like stuck there waiting for it to go up and be like, I can't get the star. And that's a kind of a thing that I worry about with emulating games as well, is like, if I start a walkthrough without knowing a game is fully completable 100%, I kind of worry if I would be able to complete a game 100% without, like, switching emulators and having all sorts of issues. Anyway, over here is the next level that I would like to go to before I end off this video. Yeah, there we go. Now, was the name Dire Docks or was it not? Oh, Jolly Roger Bay, okay. Dire Docks is the later level with the sub. I got him confused. Ah, the beautiful music. It soothes my soul. It makes me not regret my confusion. Okay, maybe not that much. So anyway, we want to go all the way down to the depths of the ocean! This isn't actually much of an ocean, it's more like a pond if you look at it. it says it's a bay, so it's definitely not an ocean of sorts. Anyway, let's get our eel friend out of here by swimming in front of him and then going back up to the surface. Hopefully that triggered him to come out of his den. And by the way, water physics, well not water physics, water life recovery is pretty broken in this game because you just go into a puddle, or anything that you can swim in, I should say, and go to the surface, you'll recover your health to the max. And it wasn't until Sunshine that they separated the air gauges, an air gauge from the power level. Anyway, I forgot the order of the chests. I think it's this one first. And give me air. Thank you. And then it is this one next. Yes, I am correct. Maybe I didn't forget the order because the last one is the middle one. There we go. And once you hit the middle one, Swim like mad behind you. Go, 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 go. Get up there before you have to do a rather annoying platforming segment of death. Well, it's not really of death, but it is really annoying. Let me up there. No, please. Let me. There we go. That's good enough. Switch to, oop, didn't mean to do that. I have the C button set to the right control stick on my Xbox 360 controller, so me hitting up like that is bound to happen somewhere along the way, because it's not like pressing a button, you know. Using a control stick is not like pressing a button. Anyway, there is the star, and that is all I'm going to be doing in this random gameplay video. I figure that this is a good enough time to end it off, because I showed you the ropes of the program. Well, not the program. I just told you about the program and told you some of the downfalls and how awesome it is despite the downfalls, because you can work around them. And yeah, I hope you give FFSplit a try, and Super Mario 64 too, of course. This is a pretty awesome game. Alright, hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you later.